All right, so we are going to discuss about data mining, and I will explain very briefly what data, already data mining, you know. What is data mining? It is basically two things, supervised and unsupervised. So what is supervised? What is supervised technique? When supervised, there is a why. What is the why? Why is the output? So whatever you have done till now, logistic regression, linear regression, advanced regression, that is offset, not offset regression, Poisson with offset, Poisson without offset, negative binomial hurdle, all these are supervised techniques. We are trying to predict something. Unsupervised techniques is there is no prediction involved. There is no output involved. Even if there is a Y in the data, which is not our variable of interest. So we have prediction and we have classification. So logistic regression is classification, linear regression is prediction. In unsupervised, we have segmentation, clustering, dimension reduction, various other things are there. We will see a few of them as part of our study. Now, the entire data mining process goes something like this. You do the data preparation and exploration under which you do sampling. We don't deal with the entire data. We do with cleaning, right? Remove unnecessary things. Remove the outliers, all that. Summaries, we have seen. You do visualization, partitioning. What is partitioning, we'll discuss. And then dimension reduction. Depending on the data, you may either do prediction or classification. If it is supervised, then you do either prediction or classification. If it is unsupervised, you do network analysis, clustering, affinity analysis. Okay? So we will see a few of these things as part of our course. And often, it is always, most of the times, data mining or any data science project is a cocktail model. It is never about one. You start with some supervised technique on top of that unsupervised, or two, three super unsupervised together. So multiple techniques are used to ultimately help your business. It is never simply your client will give you adipose tissue based circumcision. No, it is never like that. It is much more detailed, much more things you have to do. First this, then that. So this is, in a nutshell, what data mining is all about. Is it clear? Now, let us go a little further on that. Let us try to understand how the supervised and unsupervised work. So before that, now let us go back to some basics. We already discussed about simple linear regression is what? X, Y, X and Y scatter plot. From this scatter plot, we build a model. Now, how do we check the error for the model? You take the measurement of all this. This is how you compute the error. Now, how did I build this model? This black line, how did I build? Build using all the blue data points, right? Now imagine I tell you all, tomorrow we are going to have examination. So as soon as I say examination, first reaction that. Then I'll say, don't worry. Take these 100 questions. Prepare well and come tomorrow. So when you come tomorrow, I give the same 100 questions. Is it clear? So how will you score? Very good, right? You will score very good. So let us say mathematics paper. Now, these 100 questions, have you learned the math or have you memorized it? You understand? When you are building a model with the entire data, the model is only memorizing it. It is not learning. The learning process is not happening. So how should I actually test your learning? I say these are some 100 questions. Let's say I have a question bank with 100 questions. From that, randomly I take 80 questions and give you. Prepare well. Understand the concepts, everything. Tomorrow when you come, I give you these 20 questions which I have not shown you. Now tell me the answer. If you are able to answer well for those 20 questions, that is the learning. You understand? So what I will do, I will retain some records. I will not give it to the model. If I have, let us say, 100 records, I will give the model only 80 records. With 80 records, let it build a model. Right? Once the model is built, I will now check if the model quality is good by checking with these records. and the quantum of error. Is it making sense? Is it clear? So this will be the true test of the model. Clear? So what we are doing here, this 100 records, I am partitioning the data into what is known as training. So this is called training data and this is called testing data. Is it clear? The concept of training and testing. So in supervised learning, what we do, we have the data, we do sampling. You have, let us say, 10 million records. You cannot build a model with 10 million or 10 this thing. Probably you take 10,000 records from them, a small sample, random sampling or whatever. Then those 10,000 records, you break it into 70-20 or 80-20 or 75-25, whatever you split it. On the training data, you perform various machine learning techniques. You do simple linear regression. If it is prediction, you do linear regression. If it is classification, you do logistic regression, right? If you are, suppose let us assume that you are doing prediction, linear regression, then you build multiple models till you get good R square. So you build model one, model two, model three, like that, you keep going. Then finally you get one model. That model, you test on the test data. If the test data accuracy is good, no problem. If it is not good, you again go here and build again. You understand? You understand the process till you get the desired accuracy. When you get the desired accuracy, this is the model you will not deploy. It is like giving the doctor the equation y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1x, the final equation when you give to the doctor. So this is where you deploy. So the new data, what is the new data? Only x. There is no y in the new data. You put that into the model and you get the y hat. Is it clear? This is a schematic representation of how supervised works. All right. Now, how does unsupervised work? Remember, in unsupervised, we don't have any prediction, so to speak of. In unsupervised, we prefer to use the entire data. Sampling doesn't work. So we take the entire data. We perform some supervised techniques on them. And based on the supervised techniques, we get, we cannot really say it is a prediction because there is no prediction. But we get some insights about the data. You use those insights for new data. So let us, we have already discussed for almost 2 days, we have discussed about supervised techniques. So now we will discuss about unsupervised techniques. Is it clear? So Indians may know this example. He picks up from your house, delivers it to your table, takes the tiffin box again, delivers it back to your house, and he charges monthly, cook's wife. No, no. Now Mumbai Dabba Wallahs also deliver in India, in Bombay. It is very crowded. Very crowded. So people use the train. Like you have your LRT, MRT here. There also use the train. But it is jam-packed. All right? You will, if you are lucky, you will be able to put your feet on the ground. Otherwise, you will be hanging. That is so crowded. Right? So people with great difficulty will enter the Mumbai train. To carry your lunch or your bag is very difficult. So people don't carry lunch. These Dabbawalas, this is an agency, they charge monthly. I remember 8 years back, it used to be 1,000. 1,000 is how much?
1,000 rupees.
1,000 rupees is how much? Approximately?
55 ringgit.
55 ringgit per month.
Now, current market.
55 ringgit per month. So they will come to your house. Your wife will keep the food outside the house in a tiffin carrier, the food box. They will pick it up. They will deliver it to your table where you are working. They will not do that. After 1 hour or 2 hours, they'll come collect it and put it back in your house. So you don't have to take the lunch. And how do they manage it? They have, if you notice here, they have a coding. So what you are seeing this box here is a case. The actual tiffin or the actual food box is inside that. This is just a case. That all this was happening because of a method of what is known as grouping, clustering it into proper locations. All right. So let us take another example. We have various shopping malls, right? Whenever you go to a shopping mall, they will ask you your mobile number. Why do they ask your mobile number? Before billing, before the billing, they will say, please give your mobile number, and then they will put the bill. Why? Because they are collecting information about you. They are collecting information about your buying behavior. So against each mobile number, they are able to find out what kind of products they buy. Now, for instance, she will go to Lulu Mall and she will buy all non-meat products, right? Somebody else will go to Lulu Mall and they'll probably buy meat-based products or things like that. Now, if there is a promotion in, let us say there is a discount in meat products, she should not get that SMS. If you receive an SMS on your phone that we have discount in meat, you have discount in rice, why they are telling me about meat? So we want to keep people like her separate group, people like somebody else separate group. So create them and then give them targeted advertisements. Is it making sense? So one method is I send a unique message to all of every individual person, which is impossible. Right? If I send you, you specifically buy, let us say, one specific type of product. So I know, okay, Shah buys these kind of products. I send her an SMS. We are having some discount on that. Why don't you join? That means for every customer, one salesman should be available, back-end officer, which is too much. Or I send a generic message to all. Then what happens? You get message about tofu. She gets message about meat, which is also not correct. So rather than sending individual messages, we create groups. 15, 20, 30, 40 groups. Similar people belong to one group. Similar people belong to one group. Similar people belong to one group. So when I send one generic message to this group, this is by and large applicable to all of them. Is it clear? So this way you are doing targeted advertisement, but not individual advertisement. Clear?